once they let it down to put the pedestal straps on that general traction motor, they should be able to raise the trucks back up to do the other one. This is a pretty expensive operation for the railroad to have to do this out on the line of road. Beat on it with your fist, that'll do it. I went and got him a hammer. Line that bolt hole up where you can put the bolt back in there. Ain't nothing more than a glorified shock absorber. Well, they got the bolt in. All right, he's picking up the pedestal strap to put it on. It's what I refer to it is. I don't know what their terminology for that is. Just a metal strap that bolts across the bottom of the pedestal to keep the journal box secured in place. Once they bolt that pedestal strap, they can pick the trucks back up and lift that traction motor right back up off the track and have room to drop it down on the next traction motor. I'm reminded of once I was putting on a tie strap when I was learning to be a carman back in 1969. The old man that was teaching us in school was named John Clark. I was trying to hold a strap up, which is 4 or 5 times heavier than that, where they could bolt it on under a draft gear. Old John looked at me and said, "Boy, get a bar and hold that thing up instead of standing there with your tongue hanging out like a dang red necktie." Colorful old character. I wrote a story about him on my website. Well, we got 4 people bolting on 1 pedestal strap. In order to get it done pretty quick. Bolting on that shock absorber do-wally too. Just got the strap on there, just need to tighten the bolts.